Hello everyone and welcome to Accounting for Foreigners in Bulgaria. I'm Iskra Kiriluva and I'm a founder and a manager of Crystal Account Consulting, a company that is providing accounting and tax consulting services in Bulgaria. Those who follow my YouTube channel already know that each time I am trying to provide information that is necessary, that is searched for, that is useful for people who intend to do business, and it's in English because I want to be understood also from the foreigners who have Bulgaria in their agenda, either for relocating here or for doing business here in Bulgaria, and I want to be understood also from them. So last week I was chatting with a very dear to me person, and we were discussing about what should be the topic of my next video, how I should choose them. And he asked me the following: have you noticed that the most most watched video in your YouTube channel is the one for setting up your company in Bulgaria? And I said yes. I took a look on it and I understood that this is the most watched video. He asked me, are you sure that you have said everything which is necessary to be said so that people understand how to set up their business in Bulgaria? And I was pretty sure, of course, I have said everything. And then I started to think, if this is the most important question for every foreigner who wants to set up business in Bulgaria, probably there is something more that should be said. And we have one problem as professionals. Knowing the things and explaining the things make us to believe that they are already known. But based on the questions I continue to receive and based on the information I have already provided many times, several times in my videos, I realize that maybe this topic still needs an explanation, and very detailed one. And I decided to make a new video, this time explaining in details every step you should make in order to register your business in Bulgaria. So let's start from there. You decide to open to register a business in Bulgaria. What you should be absolutely clear about is that when you are registering a company in Bulgaria, your company is legal entity that is absolutely different from you in your capacity of individual. In that sense, I also got a question about this. The question was the following: can I continue to live in my, you know, homeland? It was a state within European Union, and to have a company registered in Bulgaria. Yes, you can. Because even if in the case when you are the sole owner, the sole shareholder of a company, this company is a legal entity, legal body, totally different, totally separate from you as in your capacity of individual. So you can be the main shareholder of this company. You can live, for instance, in Portugal, but your company could be registered in Bulgaria and can be, and it will be Bulgarian legal entity and doing business according to the rules of Bulgaria. The second thing, who can do the registration of your company in Bulgaria? And now, before I get into details, I will mention the following. I am providing the details for registration of the most popular legal form of company in Bulgaria. And this is a limited liability company. In the case of sole owner, it's a EOD in Bulgaria. And all the info and details I'm providing is related to this form of doing business, because this is the most popular and the most used form of business in doing business in Bulgaria. So, who can register your company? Your company could be registered into the Registry of Commerce in Bulgaria only by two type of people. One is you as individual, as sole owner of the capital of this company, and the other one is an attorney with a special power of attorney granted to him, who can deposit the documents related to your new Bulgarian company registration. How it can be done? It can be done in person by the two type of individuals I just described, or the documents, the package of the documents, can be submitted electronically in case one of both has a so-called electronic signature. This is a certificate you obtain as individual from one of the, I think there are four companies in Bulgaria who are providing this type of electronic signatures. And there is no obstacle so that you can obtain this electronic signature by yourself as individual. But you have to be present in person in the moment of obtaining this electronic signature. The companies are checking your ID, checking the details of the applications and etc. And they just grant you some, you know, small USB device with a card on it where your electronic signature is recorded. So, if you have your digital certificate, you can apply online for the registration of your company. Nevertheless, the package of the documents is one and the same. And in the case you are presenting, or your lawyer is presenting the documents in person, he just provides a notarized copy of it. In case you are submitting it online, you again have to fulfill all the requirements related to the document, but you just scan and send them during the online application form. What you should know about the taxes. If you submit your application for new company registration in person, the taxes are one amount. I mean the official state taxes of the commercial register. If you are submitting the whole package of documents related to the registration online, then the tax is in most cases half of the regular fee, which is asked when you present the documents in person, in paper, in hard copy during the registration of your company. Currently, the standard fee for registration of new company in a commercial register related to EOD, which is limited liability company, is 110 Bulgarian leva, which is approximately 55 euro. In case you deposit the package of the registration documents electronically and you apply electronically, the price is half. It is 55 Bulgarian leva, which is more or less 25 euro. So you have decided that you are going to register a company in Bulgaria. What you should know in advance prior to effect this procedure of registration your company and submitting your, you know, the package of documents to the commercial register in Bulgaria. First, there is a package of documents, which are standard documents, standard legal documents, which are necessary to be fulfilled and to be submitted via your company registration process in a commercial register. Who can prepare these documents for you? These documents are usually prepared for you by a legal advisor, an attorney, who has a pretty clear, you know, vision and idea what they should contain, how they have to be prepared. And usually the lawyers are doing this, are preparing this package of documents as a whole. And also they do the registration on your behalf in case you entitle them to do so with the power of attorney. And they can register your company so that you have, you know, your ready company within several days. Who can offer you this type of services? The preparation of the documents can be done via, there are a lot of companies in Bulgaria represented online. You can apply to one of those companies. They can prepare the documents for you. They can send you the forms. You have to fill them in to send them back to the office and to show up to sign them. First of all, some of the documents need a notarization. One good example of this document is the sample of your signature, which is a package, which is part of the package of the registration documents. So for some of the documents, you need a notarization. And the notarization is done only in person by you as individual who is incorporating this limited liability company in front of the notary office. There, the notary just checks your identity card, your identification, and you sign the document in front of him, and he certifies this notarization with the stamp, the respective stamp on the document. Only the notarized documents can be submitted as a part of, the whole package. Not all of them need notarization, but some do need. That means that you should show up at a notary office in person to do this procedure so that you can submit later on the documents to the lawyer's office and they can continue with registration of your company. That means that at some point, for some limited period of time, you should show up in person in Bulgaria in order to fulfill these legal procedures so that the registration of your company can continue even without you being on the territory of Bulgaria. Is there another way about this? Of course there is. All these things could be done via entitled person, usually a lawyer, via power of attorney, but first, the process takes much more time, it's longer, it's much more costly, and the outcome of this process is not so sure that it will be, the positive one which you desire. Therefore, I strongly recommend that you show up in person for the registration of your company, and then if you do not have intention to continue to, a resident in Bulgaria, you can go wherever you want, but your company is already registered. For the registration process, you need to be here for a limited period of time and in person. The second very tricky question, which is very tricky currently, is which also requires your presence in person in Bulgaria, is the opening of bank account of your company. This question became tricky, let's say, in the last 1 year, I suppose. In the time after, having enforced the act for the measures for preventing money laundering. What did it change about the investment process and the company registration processes in Bulgaria? The certificate from the bank that you have deposited your company capital is part of the documents, of the whole documents package necessary for the registration of your company. The banks usually open, bank accounts only if the owner shows up in person at their office. Why is that? Because they are making, background checks in order to ensure that all the regulations of this law are respected. You know very well that the banks are very big and huge structures. Most banks in Bulgaria are foreign ones, branches of foreign ones. And as such, they just fulfill the regulations of the, headquarters, and they just follow the procedures. First of all, it was necessary that they adapt their internal procedures very quickly. Some of them managed, some of them didn't. And when it is coming to, respecting the law, if you are a, huge bank, you prefer to be on a safe side. So what do they do? If you want to open a company, they usually make a background check of you as individual. And the chances that they open account of your future company without any problem is much higher if you are an individual coming from European Union, because they have, you know, their sources to make these checks within the territory of European Union, and the possibility for positive outcome are increasing significantly. Without this bank certificate for the capital of your company, it is not possible for you even to register your company. This document is part of the whole documents package. So it's better for you to be present here in Bulgaria in front of the bank office you have chosen to open your future company capital, special capital account, and to fix this procedure by yourself to obtain the certificate, and later on to proceed in the way you want to proceed via, using the service of a lawyer or doing the registration yourself, electronically, in person, it doesn't matter. What matters is that you obtain this certificate for the capital of your company deposited, and you do it in person, because the chances are dropping significantly if you are using a person to do this for you, entitled, of course, with a power of attorney, which is notarized, etc. Otherwise, the documents are not going even to be screened by the bank. So just have this into consideration when you are making your plans for opening business in Bulgaria. You have to be present here for a limited period of time, because in the mass case, this procedure for opening, the bank account and notarizing some of the registration papers should not take, let's say, more than a week for you. More than a week stay in person on the territory of Bulgaria. Once the documents are already prepared, especially this bank certificate, then you can go in your homeland, and the procedure could be finished by your attorney, or you can finish it online, or whatever choice you make. Just be sure that you have all the documents which are required by the law in advance in order to be able to proceed further. In the lights of this last year changes, I should mention the fact that due to these background checks the banks are doing on the individuals who want to set up a company in Bulgaria to register a limited liability company. Due to this increased number of background checks, some of the banks started to introduce some fees for performing these services. Some of them, the fees are significant. Some of them, but still continue to, provide this service for a very reasonable, fees, which are absolutely affordable, something like 20 Bulgarian leva or something like similar or a bit more. But I should warn you that there are banks in Bulgaria who, perform this service upon very serious taxes, like to 150 euro or even more. What is the other threat here? The bank can make this background check, and this check is mostly related that you are, with a clean background record, criminal record, that you are not performing money laundry and etc. So if you are, with a clean background, you shouldn't be afraid of any, difficulties arising. I'm not saying that it is not possible that some confusion happens or whatever. But I'm saying that if you are a citizen of the European Union, living, having a permanent address on the territory of one of the European states, and your background is clear, you shouldn't be afraid. You do not have grounds to have a serious, you know, problems or serious chances to get a refusal of opening this bank account. What you should be aware of, and you should prepare in advance before you are going to the bank for opening your bank account, your company future bank account. You should be aware of the following. You have to prepare first the decision for the incorporation of your company, because this is one of the documents the bank will require from you in order to start the procedure of opening this special capital bank account of your future company. The second thing is the articles of incorporation of your company. Both documents are prepared, of course, are part of the package of the documents, but can be prepared by almost every lawyer for you, so that you have to fill in just the details which are related for you, to sign it, because they do not need notarization, and to take it with you in the bank office to use them in order to open your special capital account for your company to be registered. The two things which are coming into, you know, consideration, mentioning those two documents. What, maybe they are not two, maybe they are more. What you have to decide upfront, prior to going to the bank and to start this procedure. You have to decide about the name of your company. You have to decide about the main activity of your company. You have to write down in these two documents I'm mentioning the address of your company. And here, if you do not have, usually what happens? For Bulgarians, the situation is the following. Usually you have, you know, your permanent registration as individual, and for the purposes of the company registration, you use your permanent address registration as individual. There is no limitation about this. But if you are not, local person, that means that you must have a tax address within Bulgaria. Usually there are companies which are offering this as a service. They are mostly accounting companies, accounting offices, lawyers' offices, etc. But tax address is kind of a service which is provided for the purposes of registration of the company. You have to be aware of these things in advance and to fulfill them in the documents necessary for opening your company special bank account. Another thing which you have to know in advance prior to going to the bank, and you have to write it down in these two documents I'm talking all the time about, the decision for opening the company and the articles of incorporation of your company to be, are the amount of the capital of your company. It has to be written down into the documents, and the same amount you have to deposit in this special bank account you are opening for the registration of your company. So, the minimum of capital required by the law here is 2 Bulgarian leven. This is 1 euro, and this is absolutely a low, you know, level of registered capital. What do I offer, what do I suggest, and what do I recommend to you is that you register your company with a bit bigger, you know, capital, because a company with a 2 leva just as a registered capital, first of all, sounds extremely, you know, unserious if you are planning to have a serious business, and second, very quickly you are getting into bankruptcy because the amount of the own capital is relatively low. What do I recommend? I would recommend that at least you register your company with something like a 1000 Bulgarian level, which is 500 euro. So you have to be ready and prepared to deposit this amount into this special company account you are going to open in the bank, and this certificate you are going to receive from the bank is part of your registration documents. So the address first, the name of the company activity, and the company capital. Those things you have, those four things you have to be absolutely aware of, and you have to be to write them down into your you know, articles of incorporation of your company and decision for opening of your company prior to go to the bank. Once again, if you are a citizen of European Union, most probably you will not have any problem with opening your bank account. It doesn't matter, it will, it can take times. It was in the past it was very quick and easy process. I am not saying that some of the banks for some of the banks it is not possible. Even currently it is possible, but for some of the banks it usually takes like days. It could take a week before they accomplish all this all these checks they are performing, and to, you know, create your company account and to grant you the certificate so that you can proceed further with registration of your business. What happens with this account once the company is registered? You are granted, you know, the registration from the trade register, from the commercial register. What happens with this account? You just take, you know, the certificate from the commercial register and you go to the bank. By the way, this certificate can be obtained also electronically, and you go to the bank, and upon this certificate the bank is transforming this special capital account into a current account of your new company. So these money are not going to be lost. I mean, they are always either yours in your capacity of individuals, or they are becoming, you know, the capital of your newly registered company. They are not going to be lost. But the question is that the bank account is going to be transformed into a current account of your new company. It is not happening automatically. You should visit your bank office once, but once it is done, then you can operate with the funds on your current bank account electronically without any limitation from each you know, point of the world where there is internet, because every bank in Bulgaria is offering, you know, internet banking. You will definitely need your current bank account for your new company because, you know, all the taxes which are due by your company, social contributions, etc., they are all paid by bank. You need to have a current account in order to accomplish this type of payments. Furthermore, I know about all these fintech companies which are offering alternative services to the bank services. Some of them are offering really good, you know, services, but still most of them do have difficulties when it comes to payment of taxes, social contributions, etc. from the respective companies, because they require a special payment form for you know, paying these obligations to the state budget and to the tax authorities. It's called budgetary payment, and most of them do not handle this you know, payment form very well. On the other side, you know, all these alternative fintech companies, They offer most, some of them offer even, you know, the IBAN for a normal, regular bank account, so you can use them, but still you need one a regular bank account in order to accomplish your obligation to the tax authorities here in Bulgaria. If you, as individual who is planning to register a company in Bulgaria, are coming from a third state outside European Union, you may meet bigger difficulties in opening this bank account, and especially if you are coming from how to say it correctly, from a state that is, you know, on the news by in the bad news related to, you know, terrorist attacks, to terrorism, to money laundry, and etc. Most probably the banks will refuse to open you your new company, such a bank account, because they prefer to be on a safe side. And there is no law which obliges them to, you know, to open this bank account for your new company. On the contrary, if they do not fulfill the regulations of this act for preventing the money laundry, the consequences for the bank could be really serious. So they prefer to just refuse to open a bank account to a new company that is meant to be opened, compared to the risk they could take if they do not fulfill, you know, the measures which are prescribed in this anti-money laundry act, and etc. I admit that this act seriously blocked, you know, the investment process in Bulgaria. There is a lot of reactions from lawyers, from, you know, business owners, from all the business society in Bulgaria against this. But so far, in the lights of what is happening in the world currently, the question is still, you know, pending. There is no, you know, decision which could be useful and could ease the process of registering a new company in Bulgaria. What else options do you have in case the bank refused to open your bank account and you still want to have a company registered in Bulgaria? The other option you have is to buy the shares of already opened, already registered company in Bulgaria. It could be with activity, it could be without activity, just registered one. And this is also a service that is provided mainly from, you know, legal attorney offices here in Bulgaria. They register the company on, you know, some individual, and then they sell you the shares of this company. What I should warn you about is that this buying the shares of an existing company, you know, process is far more costly. It is requiring more documents in order to accomplish this deal, so that the ownership of the company is changed again. It is made in, you know, a commercial register who is responsible for registering companies in Bulgaria, and it will cost you more money. But still, it is an option. To have a Bulgarian registered company without the necessity to open the bank account upfront prior to registration of your company. The procedures for you know, writing down this change, registering this change into commercial registers are more complicated, the fees are higher, and etc. And the fees of the lawyers, of course, are higher, because this is, you know, more time consuming and, you know, preparation necessary process. But still, this is an option if you need to have a Bulgarian registered company and you have some difficulties with opening this bank account. And again, if you are an individual who is, you know, a citizen of one of the European Union state members, You can continue to live in your homeland. You can have a permanent address in your homeland, and you can have absolutely clearly company in Bulgaria. If you are an individual who is coming from a third state outside European Union, the banks usually want you to have some residence address on the territory of Bulgaria in order to proceed your documents, in order to open your bank account so that you can register your own company. It is possible depending on, reputation your homeland has, but still it is absolutely possible. They just need to prove that you have serious intentions and that you have some, residence address in Bulgaria, which confirms that your serious intention to be in Bulgaria, to live in Bulgaria, to do business in Bulgaria, so that they can make, their background checks and everything to be on a safe side in fulfilling the requirements of this Anti-Money Laundering Act. And once again, as a recap, you can do all these things, all these registration, procedures by your own and by using a legal advisor. Both are possible, both are, a matter of, budget, costs, etc. And for the special, procedures like the notarizing and opening of the bank account, you can again do it in your homeland, for instance, the notarization, but then it needs, the document needs also apostille, which is the certification that this document needs in order to be recognized by another state. And what comes for the power of attorney, if you choose to use this method of registering your company in Bulgaria, it is possible. Everything is possible, but I'm just speaking based on my experience. The chances are dropping significantly down if you use a kind of a, attorney with power of attorney to do these things for you. Better plan your 1 week visit to Bulgaria and organize these things by yourself, because in every case, it will be much easier if you, as individual who is, a sole shareholder of this company, is here in person just for the notary and for the opening of the bank account. It's easier, it costs you less money, and it will increase significantly the chances that you have your company registered. One last thing which I forgot to mention to you. When you are picking your company name, you have to choose very carefully so that to avoid that this company name is already taken. There is a service, again, in this commercial register, which is a service for, booking of the name. It costs some money in addition, but if you want to be on a safe side when you register your company, I strongly recommend that you book your company name prior in advance, so that you are sure that this company name is not taken and it is, reserved for you. It is reserved for a period of time, I don't remember, I think it was 6 months or something, so it will... for this period of time, you are safe that this name is not going to be taken by anyone else. And of course, if you have serious intentions to register business in Bulgaria, for 6 months you have to, you should be absolutely clear where you are going, if the process is successful or not. 6 months are enough period of time for accomplishing this task. Because why it is important? Because if everything is perfect within the package of the documents you're prepared for the registration of your company, if there is a duplication of the name, the commercial register officers will refuse to register your company based only on the duplicate of the name. So be very careful when you are choosing your company name. Use something which, if you do not intend to book your name company name in advance. Just use something that you suppose is more or less unique, and you are significantly, you know, lowering this chance to get a refusal for registration just based on the fact that your company name already exists and is taken by some other company. So that's all for now. Now I hope this time the detailed information provided, the detailed description of the procedure is going to be more effective for you, so that you get all the picture overview about your plans, your intentions to register a company in Bulgaria and do business in Bulgaria. You can, if you need assistance, if you need accounting services, you can get in touch with me too. You can reach me on the email, you can reach me on the website, you can reach me on the LinkedIn or Facebook page of Crystal Account Consulting and my personal ones. You can reach me on the YouTube channel Accounting for Foreigners in Bulgaria. Feel free to subscribe, feel free to comment, feel free to ask questions, because you see, I am creating these videos just with the intention to provide useful information for you based mainly on your questions. And if you like the information which I share, please subscribe or share the info so that it can reach to more people that are looking for this type of information. So thanks for watching this video. Till next Wednesday, stay fine, stay tuned, and see you.